students, and cannon fodder coppers. Senior police and government sources are expecting monthly protests over the next few years. The media response to G20 made the police look heavy-handed. In the year 2010, students had good reason to protest. The newly formed condemned government were making the rich richer by taking food from the poor. The police had their numbers and wages under threat. Students were told that only the rich would become educated in the future. Then, on 10/11/10, someone played a game. Student protests became the platform. Media smiles were the prize. The risk, our lives. Who were the players? The media response made the police look like victims, made the students look like perpetrators, and gave the condemns a moral right to put through any changes they liked in the future. But it was an unfair fight planned by politicians and police management. Senior riot police and management knew of the potentials for violence on the 10th of November. Anarchist websites showed their intention for weeks beforehand. Police monitor these anarchist sites. Police management say they made a genuine mistake. They say they only expected 1,000 protesters, a few anarchists, and that 225 officers would have been enough. Senior sources say management on the day expected at least 25,000 protesters, but backup was not called. Why not? Was it because politicians and police needed an incident? Initially, 20 officers were sent to Millbank. A crowd of hundreds had gained entry to the building. The crowd grew into thousands and became hostile, pushing and pulling. The 20 faced them for 1.5 hours before a small team of riot police came to their rescue. There are 40,000 police officers in London. But why did they not help? Riot police had arrived 15 minutes after the start of the disturbance. Management told them not to deploy, not to rescue their colleagues. Many other units attending the scene were told to turn back and leave. All London Borough Police were given strict instructions not to attend. 20 officers made several emergency calls, saying their lives were under threat. Yet, they fought the crowd on their own for 2 hours. The police were massively outnumbered by the crowd. Had the number of anarchists within them been higher, the outcome may have been far more severe. Missiles were thrown constantly and a fire extinguisher flung from the roof. Baroness Warsi, the Tory chairperson, was on the third floor all this time. If only the crowd knew, they could have spoken to her and got a direct ear to the government policymakers. The conclusion, the winners, the losers, the conspiracy, the truth. A country where the people care, where the government does not. But the police are cannon fodder, and the government their paymasters. Protest is rising. Politicians and police are expecting it and need to control us. Cameron the police, the anarchists the rich, the poor the students, or the cannon fodder coppers. Whose side are you on?
Look at your women crying, look at your young men dying, the way they've always done before. Look at the the hate we're breeding. Look at the fear we're feeding. Look at the lives we're leading. The way we've always done before.
Don't want